Hey guys, welcome back. Today I'm going to be showing you my curly to straight routine. I'm going to show you how I go from this 3, 4, 5 day old wash and go that's looking very busted to this silky smooth flat ironed look. So if you guys are interested in seeing how I get my hair this smooth and silky, please stay tuned. Ladies, so the first step is pre-shampoo. I use virgin coconut oil that I pick up from Whole Foods or Trader Joe's, and I slather this on my hair very generously, making sure to cover all sections of it. I also do very light finger detangling at this point, but one thing that I want to warn is to be very, very gentle when finger detangling because my hair is in a dry state and I can definitely pull out tons of strands if I'm not careful. So I do this to all sections of my hair, and when I'm done lightly finger detangling each section, I twist it up and move on to the next, and then place a shower cap on my head for about 30 minutes. I then move on to shampoo, condition, and deep condition. The next step is product application. Now you want to use a good base when deciding to straighten your hair. So I start with the Keratin and Green Tea Restructurizer, which is gonna build the protein up in my hair that of course will be, you know, worn down from the heat. So I spray this all over my hair generously, making sure that I cover each section, then move on to my leave-in. Now my leave-in of choice is the As I Am Leave-In Conditioner, which is a new product that I've just started using. It gives me great slip, and it's definitely very, very moisturizing, which you want in a leave-in, since your hair will be straight for a week or however long you decide to leave it straight. So I put about that much, or maybe a little more, on each half of my head before detangling, and follow up with my Pure Aloe Vera Juice. After my products are applied, I then take my wide tooth comb and lightly detangle my hair. Now what I do to prepare my hair, because I'm going to dry it overnight, is just basically do 2 pigtail braids on the sides just so my roots will lay down flat and I can keep my hair out of the way and air dry it, which also reduces the amount of heat that I put on my hair since I'm not blow drying it or doing any other type of manipulation to it. And then I just pretty much go to bed for the night with a scarf over my head. So the next morning, I'm greeted with all this fullness here. It dried overnight in the braids and va-voom, that's all I have to say. So what I'm going to use is this generic brand Silk Remedy as my heat protectant. I picked it up from Sally's, and I'll be flat ironing with my Solia flat iron, which works wonderful. And you can't see, but I'm trying to show you the temperature that it's on. I set mine to 370 usually. Of course, if your hair is thicker than mine, you should up the temperature, and if it's thinner than mine, you may want to lower it. It's all just what you feel comfortable with. I've always flat ironed my hair at 370 and I haven't had any heat damage, thank goodness. So that's what works for me. So what I do is take very small pieces, and as you can see with my comb, I use the side with the, I guess, wider space teeth first and then detangle with it and then flip it to the other side and use the one with the teeth that are closer together. And I use the chase method with my comb. Many people use brushes or other tools with it, and it's basically just using the tool and then following your flat iron behind it. And this gives me like the smoothest flat iron possible with only going over each strand like twice. And really the second time I'm only going past it because I need to make sure my ends are a little bit straighter. And even here, like, the reason that I really went over it twice is because my ends are in need of a trim badly. But otherwise, I'd probably only have to do it once. So here, I'm going to show you a close-up of what I do again. Of course, detangle with each side of my comb. And then follow up with the chase method. As you can see, I'm constantly moving my flat iron. This is in real time. I don't keep it on each of the sections for a long period of time. Anything that I can do to, you know, prevent heat damage, I'm all for that. So this is my second pass, and that's pretty much, I only do it twice. That's it. No third time here. And as you can see, it gets my hair very, very smooth. Of course, some parts of my roots are still a bit wavy, but since this is the back, it really doesn't bother me. And here are my results. It's got tons and tons of body. It's flowing, it's super soft. And I am absolutely in love with it. Tons of movement, very, very lightweight. And what I do to preserve my hair is basically just wrap it overnight. Or I'll put it in a loose bun at the top of my head. But these are my results. If you guys have any questions about my flat ironing routine, please don't hesitate to leave them in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching.